Well, this is a bit embarrassing. I must apologize for the audio quality of this next episode. I was trying something new with my audio capture setup, and unfortunately, none of the game audio ended up being recorded. I've learned a valuable lesson about keeping alternate save states available to re-record episodes in the future, but for now, unfortunately, this next episode is going to be largely my voice. In order to make up for it somewhat, I have found copies of the music online, and I will be inserting at least major themes where applicable. Certainly, most of it takes place in Figaro Castle, so the Figaro theme will be playing, and I've added the battle music where necessary, but the audio quality will not be particularly good as it is all somewhat synthesized together afterwards. Again, I must apologize. Hello, gorgeous, and welcome back to Final Fantasy III. Let's get into the game. So here we are again with Locke and Terra. And I'm hoping that this first place I've encountered is. Where I'm supposed to go, but I suppose first I should fight some creepy scorpions. Depending on how the game goes, I may need to do a bit of level grinding off screen at some point, but for now I think we're doing okay. Ah, here we are! Figaro! Where they told us to go. I can't talk to the Chocobo riders. Oh, and they don't. Wait! Oh, it's you, proceed. I suppose Locke is known to these people? Let's do a bit of exploring before we find this cave. Why does this castle have an engine room? Oh, they don't want us to go down there. And there are apparently thieves in this dungeon. Very hyperactive. And those cells are quite tiny. Doesn't seem so nice. Oh, and they have air conditioning? I suppose something. It's an interesting aesthetic for the castle. They don't want me to be exploring. Everyone just tells me to go see the king. Doesn't look like it, but this castle incorporates some of the most high-tech devices in existence. Oops, they're all top secret. Does actually quite look like it. Interesting aesthetic. I wonder why the castle is on its own out in the desert, though. It's a bit odd, don't you think? Well, and these people are just telling me to see the king again. I mean, he's right there. Locke has introduced him to Tara. Oh, he's quite too forward. But at least he apologized about that. I guess this character is some sort of ladies' man aesthetic. Archetype, I apologize. How rude of me to turn my back on a lady. Well, is this one of our main characters? The young king of Figaro Castle, ally to the Empire and a master designer of machinery, is this our Cid? No, his name is Edgar, okay. I saw master designer of machinery and I assumed. I am Edgar, king of Figaro. Locke, I'm not entirely surprised that you knew a king. Oh, but Locke is leaving. But I'm not an Imperial soldier, I was brainwashed. It's not in my blood to harm a lady, ugh. I'm not even going to bother with his voice. And Tara is, of course, immediately suspicious. Apparently our beauty has captivated Edgar. He wants to know if he's our type. And, in a distant third reason, he is helping because of our magic. Tara just doesn't understand this kind of person. No, I don't believe your technique is rusty, Edgar. I think you're just not very suave. Oh, Tara. Don't be down on yourself. I suppose we should follow him? Are you going to say anything to- Oh, yes. Feel free to wander about. I will. Oh, they're all rather worried about the Empire's new use of magic. He doesn't say anything new. Hopefully we can explore these other areas now. It's the most modern structure in the world. Scholars world over are doing research on magic. Why would you call them silly? You're clearly a scholar yourself. People who used to use magic were called mage knights. Oh, I can get out here to the Chocobo Islands. They don't really have much to say. There is a South Figaro. This appears to be not just a castle, but a manufactory. for what I'm assuming is more of an agricultural and population center type area. You say that Figaro and the Empire are allies, but... Oh. I suspect that will no longer be true after a while. Yes, I will take a rest. I'm glad to see that most of them seem to have the same impression of Edgar that I do. Oh dear, he hit on the High Priestess. Really, we should have higher standards for our leader. Edgar has a twin brother. He was such a nice boy. Oh, but he is no longer? Oh, getting some kind of flashback. Oh, that when their father died. Was dying? Poor Edgar. Edgar's twin brother who traded the throne for his own freedom, and is apparently another of our characters. His name is Sabine. He looked so like his father. When he ran away, he was a sweet little child. I wonder what he's like now. Sad. Well, and even these soldiers realize their alliance with the Empire is likely not to last. Oh dear, I did not mean to leave. I do rather need to recover my party members. I think I don't know where they've gone. They still won't let me in the engine room. This person does not seem particularly humane. Oh, there is some sort of real threat? Who gives himself the nickname Lone Wolf? What prisons ever are humane, but anyway. Let's see. must be missing something. According to the Chancellor, it was specifically because the succession was awkward that Sabine left. They settled the matter with a coin toss. That is quite awkward. The Edgars come back. Someone from the Empire has come to see him. Oh dear, it's Kefka. Three Emperor Gestal's stupid orders. Edgar, you pinhead, why do you have to live in the middle of nowhere? These recon jobs are the pits. There's sand in my boots. Oh dear. Oh, and listen to that synthesized laughter. What a jerk. Oh, I'm Edgar now. I thought we were allies. What are you doing in my domain? Looking for more cities to destroy? Surprised they managed to figure out where Terra is. There are rumors of a wandering witch. But Kefka insists that she's a simple thief. Oh, Edgar. I'd hate to be you if we found out you're lying. Mwahahaha! I truly hope nothing happens to your precious Figaro. It's like a mobster. This is a nice castle you have here. Well, I suppose now that I am Edgar, I should go. Make sure that Terra has not run off. Oh, there she is. I'm sure you do hate being king. Now it's just me and Locke again. Given that Edgar was level 8, we probably should have spent a little bit more time leveling up with the other two. Don't worry about a thing. Oh. T- Tara doesn't seem to trust any of them, which is quite fair. Edgar told me you're a thief. Is it true? That's treasure hunter. Of course, Edgar's collaboration with the Empire is all a ruse. He's truly working with the Returners, the Resistance Movement. And Locke is his contact. As is the old man from Narsh. No, Tara, you're not. You were brainwashed. They were using you. Things are different now. She's so confused. You don't have to decide right now. You'll soon find your own way. Tara, how will I know which way is right? This music is rather ominous. They attacked Figaro? Oh, everything's on fire. Yes, Kefka has attacked. I'm Edgar again. He's insisting that we bring Tara to him, but Edgar insists that we don't have her, and Kefka doesn't seem particularly to care. Well then, welcome to my barbecue! Can I fight him? No, it simply gives me the same dialogue. Oh, I believe now it is going to turn into combat. Oh, they're going to flee. Shameful for a king should flee, leaving his people behind. How utterly delightful. Kefka. Now we have fled on chocobos. Oh, it's not just a castle. Submerge mode. It's some kind of... No one can touch the people of Figaro. Apparently their castle is some kind of sand submarine. We've left poor Kefka out in the desert. But he's sending his Magitek soldiers after us on... Oh dear, those look quite terrifying. Oh no, what's happening to Edgar? Oh, he's terrified of... Oh no, he's terrified of Tara's magic. Oh, terrified isn't the right word. She's amazing! Locke simply didn't realize she was using magic before. She's a bit unobservant. You know, we were in the middle of a fight. Is now really the time? Oh, now they're apologizing for embarrassing her. Well, she doesn't remember where she learned how to use magic. Does she? Aw, oh, Locke, you're so sweet. Tara can use magic and we can't. That's the only difference between us. Thank you, Locke. Aw. Did she just wink at them? I'm not quite sure that's how that was supposed to go. Son of a Submariner? Quite the turn of phrase, Kefka. Oh, Terra is scared. Kefka is quite terrifying at times. But Edgar is going to take us to meet more of the Returners? Yes, our mentor, Bannon, would certainly like to meet you. Magic is going to be the key to winning this war. How did Edgar know that the Esper in the mines reacted to her? Somehow I doubt that's how Terra talks. It just seems natural to me that I have the use of this power. Now he's questioning our humanity. Edgar. Terrified the poor girl. Oh dear. Sure, the Empire is going to come after you. They get your hands on you again. The world's finished. Overly dramatic there, Edgar. Terra, you won't understand your powers, right? Then I think we need to consult with Bannon. Please. To the south, there's a cave that leads to South Figaro. All right, and we're back on the map. And we're going to... Oh, we are on chocobos now. Lovely mode 7 effects. But I can't appear to... Oh no. Oh no, can I get back on the chocobo? Well, we're not on chocobos anymore, unfortunately, but I'm going to save for the time being. And thank you very much for coming back and joining me on this journey through Final Fantasy III. Have a lovely day, gorgeous.